Hello everyone, this is Mr. Brass, and today I'm going to be talking about my view on marriage. Now, the debate between gay marriage is a strong one, but I will say, even as a Christian, I never got why the government had to be involved in this particularly. I hold that we should privatize marriage in a way that models a standard business contract. Have two or more individuals set the terms of their own enforceable private marital contract that talks about marriage, children, etc., with a third party. The business they go to would be called upon to enforce said contract if violated. A free market approach would give people a choice, and like business contracts, they will naturally have constraints while also being much more flexible than what they are now. It would also serve to lower the price for weddings while increasing the quality of weddings. Divorcing would just be seen as the same as opting out of a contract. Marriage and government institutions privileges one sort of relationship over others. With gay marriage, it creates the expectation that only legit gay relationships are the marital ones. The problem isn't government recognizing loving relationships, it's government dismissing other loving relationships by an arbitrary standard that may have made sense in ancient times when women and men relationships were like business deals, but no longer holds in our individualistic modern society. Now, inevitably, what will be brought up is, what about the benefits the government gives married people? For one, these really aren't benefits per se, but more as baby-making incentives. The idea was, when they gave these benefits out, is that by giving the couple more of their own money back, that they would feel more comfortable having kids, and once they did have kids, the money the government would get from the kids would pay off the marriage benefits. Essentially, you're paying for the benefits you get just indirectly through your kids. A marital corporation following supply and demand would have little need for said presumption of reproduction, as they could make their money through many other avenues that don't require kids. Also, one must realize that a lot of these benefits are also made possible by paying taxes, and I don't think it's legit to threaten a Christian at gunpoint to pay for gay couples' benefits any more than I think it's legit to force a gay couple to pay for the benefits of a homophobic straight Christian couple. Another thing is, a lot of these benefits, i.e. like inheritance, are available to regular non-marital couples, and all they'd have to do is go through a lawyer, and the ones that aren't, there is no reason why those benefits shouldn't be available to the public. So marriage shouldn't be a requirement to obtain those benefits in the first place. On top of it all, having these benefits ensures that many people will get married solely because of the financial incentive and not because of actual love, which is something that I would say hurts members of all communities and actually has been used as a way for people to have fraudulent gay marriages simply for the benefits, so all parties suffer here. As Colin Jones pointed out in his paper on the subject, I have an unabashedly heterosexual female friend who works for a major corporation. Because she lives in Massachusetts, where same-sex marriages were recently legalized by judicial fiat, she has started talking about marrying one of her best girlfriends for the sole purpose of giving her friend access to the company's health care benefits. Fraudulent, some might say, but why not? Does anyone want to get into the business of determining who is really gay and who is not? Once gays can get married in same-sex unions, why can't heterosexuals? And if my friend can marry her friend to get spousal benefits, why can't I do the same for my widowed mother or my brother? If marriage is not at least presumptively about reproduction anymore, there is no real reason to disallow any of these marriages. These benefits only serve to give government undeserved and unnecessary power and make matrimony a monopoly product. With a free market, it would also be possible that the couples could potentially get more benefits, as the partnership could be tailored to their own wants and needs, and certain benefits would be the subject to supply and demand, and so all the necessary benefits people want would be available at a much better cost and quality for them. A lot of people go into love and when talking about marriage, but here's the thing, for most of history of the institution, marriage wasn't even about love, but just about allying with families and expanding a labor force. It also ensured the legitimizing of kids through inheritance. Mutual attraction didn't even become important till about 100 years ago. The notion of love matches is only about 250 years old, really. It was common to just marry a guy or girl your family told you to marry, and you would fall in love with them over time. In America, statheism is the largest religion in America, where the government is seen as some sort of collection of demigods who have access to information of how to solve problems that the experts and major businesses don't even know how to fix. It's seen as even if though experts in these businesses on this problem can't understand how to solve a problem, that somehow government, which is another group of people whom likely aren't expert in this business, somehow knows how to fix it. People assign so many godlike attributes to government, such as it loves people enough to do the just thing for all of them, when in reality the government doesn't care who you're in love with, or even if the person you're marrying is someone you love. The government cares about producing results just like a business, which is why redefining marriage as love really makes no sense, as love isn't an objective standard by which to measure anything. We went from an actual objective value for measuring whether or not we should allow a certain marriage, i.e. through whether or not it overall serves society in a beneficial way, to just what subjective notion of love is legit. A lot of time we hear this battle between gay activists and religious conservatives who want to manipulate the government to get what they want. Now, on both sides, there are people I agree with. For example, I agree with old school gay activists that state marriage has been a way for the government to control family through tax code. And on the religious conservative side, I can see how having a state institution controlling marriage can potentially violate their sacred values. I think privatizing is the best for both worlds with them, as for one, it ensures religious freedom, as a religious person could have a religious wedding if they so choose to, and don't have to worry about being accused of discrimination and worrying about their freedoms being limited, while also it would give gay people the ability to get married in their institutions of their choice without worrying about fundy Christians trying to halt them through the legal system. They both could go to their own marital corporations that are like-minded like them and would bring more money to the already rich marriage institution and would also allow for possible charitable causes to arise from the newly acquired wealth. A fault that I believe the religious conservative did was that they worried so much on defining marriages between a man and woman, which fed into the rights of gay people, like the civil rights. What they should have done is tried to define marriage as a religious institution and thus have asked the government to get out of it, which, funny enough, old school gay activists would have agreed with, as atheist Brendan O'Neill reported on in an article. I also agree on both libertarian and utilitarian grounds that the church is justified in current day to not want to ordain openly gay people or even to bless same-sex unions. Appeals to just as a homosexual activity is harmless, attempts to change sexuality are damaging, and it's all innate, all in the grand scheme of things fail to show why the church should change its policy on it. At most, only 10% of the population is homosexual, and even fewer have any interest in getting their relationships blessed by the church, so only few would benefit from the change. And even having the blessing is minimal, as even heterosexual couples are increasingly going without it for better options. Symbolic value of changing the policy doesn't work either, as bigots generally won't change their mind on homosexuality given a policy change, and all it would do in the end is cause dissension in the church and would undermine the authority of the church, which Christians depend on for comfort and communal worship. I disagree with them, however, on the same grounds that homosexual activities in of themselves are harmful, and I would say it would depend on whether it maximizes utility. Plus, that such regulation of the activity will not lead necessarily to group cohesiveness, and would just be hard to enforce. For the same reason, gay ordained priests, at least at this time, shouldn't be endorsed. Plus, in that case, having them in such an open position would leave them at the wrath of bigoted members of the church. Now, people against this idea say that government will have to be involved and that religious institutions would create their own marriage laws. We should note that we already have family court, which takes care of children born to unmarried parents, so irregardless of what we do with marriage, that won't go away. As far as religious institutions being able to create their own marriage laws, it would be true that a definition of marriage espoused by a religious community would be endorsed, but it would also be true that these laws couldn't be a counter to the laws in the already established jurisdiction. Again, states have their own way of going about this already. On a plus side, couples would get to work out the details of their contract, which would likely help when a divorce happens, and legal templates for private marriages would emerge, with states also establishing civil unions in absence of couples pursuing private alternatives. Like gay couples prior to the Supreme Court ruling, matters of cohabitation, property, inheritance, etc. would be discussed by the couples. Now, would this solve all the problems with marriage? No, of course not. But at least it would be a step in the right direction and would help people be more happier than they currently are now. Well, that is all for today. This is Mr. Brass saying goodbye and get wise.